Hello procrastinators, moneymakers, also YouTubers, Laserjet here, and welcome to Train Simulator 2017. And today we are doing a review on the E2 LBSC Tank Engine. I messed that up, but never mind. Today we are reviewing this amazing, spectacular tank engine, and this was actually given to me as a gift from a fan called Mark the Blue Brony, and I actually want to give him a massive thanks, and I give him a shout out as well for letting me have this this add-on pack. So thank you to Mark the Blue Brony. Make sure you subscribe to his YouTube channel, because a lot of people have been giving me a lot of ideas and they've been giving me a lot of packs lately, and I just want to take this time to say thank you to all of you for, you know, giving me all the your awesome packs and your awesome ideas for my Train Simulator series. So, you know, thank you so much for, you know, support and your love and share. It's just been amazing. So anyway, today we are in somewhere in the UK. I have no idea where we are, but all I know is that this is a nice place, and we're gonna be driving and reviewing this train, because this is just an awesome pack and a massive, like, it's a great add-on to have on this Train Simulator episode, because this train has realistic sound effects and it has a special feature inside, like underneath the train. It's got all these pipe, you can't really see that, they've got all these pistons and, you know, stuff, and it's something that a normal tank engine would have, and it's like, and it's really cool. And I think this was the tank engine that Thomas was supposed to be based on, I'm not entirely sure. But if we have a look inside, we've got this amazing detail inside the cab, and we've got these funny little doors which we can open. So we can open on that one on that side. We can also open this one on this side. So, you know, that's a really cool feature, and I like it. This model is just so well detailed, and the sound effect, as I said, is fantastic. So if we put the regulator on 29 and have the brakes off, and then have the throttle on 15%. You have a look outside, and before we leave, well, we are leaving, but let's do a quick little whistle, and away we go. We'll put up a little bit of bone power. I think we'll have it on 62%, and if we press C, then you get this amazing sound and smoke effect that comes out of the front of the steam engine, and that just looks so cool. Right, let's turn it off because it's really loud. And already we're picking up some speed, and if you look, you can see the pistons underneath the wheels moving, which I really like here, which that's a really cool feature on this train. And it's just, this tank engine's so cool, and I'm still very grateful for Mark for letting me have this pack. Thank you so much. And if we press control shift then one, we get this like white circle on top of the engine. If we hold down shift two, control shift two, then control shift three, then control shift four, then control shift five, it only goes up to five, then we get all these circles, but for the fifth one you get a red one. I don't really know what these are for, but if you guys know what these are for, then let me know. But I think I should have one at the top and one there. I think that means passenger, or maybe freight. I don't know. I'm not a train expert, but we are really picking up some speed right now. We're doing 49.9. No, we're doing 15 miles per hour. Okay, let's just slow down a little bit. We don't want to go too fast because we don't want to derail and then we're back to square one again, because that would be disastrous. And at this point of the video, you're probably wondering why I'm doing a review on this tank engine. You guys probably don't even like this tank engine, but I'm going to be honest with you. If I like this, then there's no doubt you guys will like it too. Right, this is coming up to a corner, so let's brake. Oh God, see, we don't want to derail. Look, we're speeding already. Right, let's just put a bit of braking on so we don't derail, because, you know, I'm a very responsible driver. But as I said, you guys are probably aware why I'm driving this. I'm not really aware, but you guys probably are guessing or asking why I'm driving this engine. And the reason why is because a fan gave me this, and he asked me if I could do a review on it, and I said yes. Why not? And because I said yes, I thought it would be a good idea to do a review on it. And plus, this is, so far the review's going well. I mean, I love this engine, and the detail on it is fantastic. I mean, you know, you got the little water tank things here, you got a whistle here or here, I don't know which one's the whistle, but I just can't get over how much detail there is on this amazing engine. And it's got realistic sound effects, which I really do like. And to be honest, this is actually a really nice engine. This is a really nice engine to drive. And it's quite fast for a tank engine, but it's not supposed to be fast. You're supposed to be driving it with gentle and with care. And because of that, it just makes it a really nice engine to drive. And I think this, so far, is one of the best tank engines I've ever driven. I mean, Thomas the Tank Engine, when I did a review on that, I mean, that was awesome. But it didn't feel nice to drive, if that makes sense. I mean, that might sound stupid to you guys, but to me, this tank engine here, this is very nice to drive. And it feels nice, and it works well on the track, and look at it. I mean, it's a tank engine, guys. Come on. I mean, look how well it's running. And it's got a realistic whistle, and they've got realistic sound effects, which I think is just amazing. And you got this awesome metal reflection-ish on the side of the boiler, which I really do like. And if we press 5, we get to go inside the carriage, which is nice, but, you know, very boring. No one really wants to see what it looks like inside a carriage. I think we're coming up to a station, so we want to apply the brakes, because there's a very sharp corner at the, I think it's the second station we're coming up to. So we want to take care. So slow down, drive with care, and do not muck it up. See, this is nice. We're cruising at a very steady 33.0 miles per hour. And the also feature I like about this is you can already see there's like little sparks flying out of the funnel, which I think that is such a very cool feature on this train as well. Like, you get like little, because I know for a fact, because I've seen steam trains work before, and I've seen a lot of sparks fly out of the funnel, and probably you guys have too. But look at, you get little sparks flying out of the funnel. I mean, they're not very well detailed sparks, but they're still sparks, and I still find that really damn cool. Anyway, I've got the regulator on 29%. The reverser is on 29%, and the regulator is on 100%. I meant to say that. So we're just cruising at a very steady 31 miles per hour, so we don't go too fast or go too slow. And to know what, this is actually a very steady pace for a tank engine. I think this is the most perfect speed ever for a train like this. Oh, and look, there's the beach. Just blow the whistle for the beach. Hello, beachlings. Beachlings is a word I made up, you know, because people like the beach, I call them beachlings. Hello, beachlings. There's absolutely no one at the beach today. I wonder why, because it's a nice sunny day and no one's at the beach. I wonder why. Right, we're coming out to a station called Watchet. I don't know what that station is, but wherever it is, I'm stopping at it. So, what we want to do is we want to just pull a little bit of power down. And we're speeding up, I don't know why. We'll have it on 0% and just let it roll. And we'll put the brakes on apply at 74, maybe a bit more, 76%. So all we're doing is we're just rolling and braking at the same time, which is quite nice, this is actually really nice. Hold on, let's just brake a bit more, don't want to overshot it. There you go, brake. And gently into the station. There we go. Oh, look at that. Oh, a little bit more power. There we go. And then brake. I think all of us are in the station. Right, just brake. Very slowly, very gently. See if we get a cool shot here of us slowing down. There you go. And it's got an awesome, I don't know guys if you can hear that, but it had a nice little squeak at the end of the braking system, and that's really cool. Right, let's open the doors, let people on and off. There we go. That was a really successful stop. I'm really pleased with myself. I never actually properly stopped at a station that well before. Until now. So yeah, that's fantastic. Right, time for me to get on the train and have my seat. I think this is my seat right here. Hello, Mr. Green Person with a very scary face. Just sit down. Ah, there we go. Lovely. Right, I think we are ready to go. Right, doors closed. All aboard. Here we go. We're off again. Oh, listen to that realistic puffing noise. Isn't that amazing? Oh my God, that is so amazing. Listen to the sound of that engine. Right, we'll have it on 50%. No, we'll have it on. Actually, we'll have it on. Have it on 25 this time. See how fast this thing can get up the hill, because there's a little hilly bit coming up. So then we need to find a way to get up the hill. And look, this. Oh, sorry, man. Did you miss your train? He's got a very scary face. Oh, he's missed his train. Oh, he's not very happy. Oh, God. I'm walking here. Thank you very much, sir. Do you mind? God, England's so awful. And I cannot deny that the detail inside the cab is more impressive than ever. I mean, you've got the reverser here, you've got the regulator here, and you've got the whistle here, which is... I don't know why the whistle's there, just don't ask why. But, and you've got the little two little water tanks here, which you can actually see how much water you've got inside, so that's actually really cool. I do like how you can open the doors, and if we go outside, you can actually see the door is actually open. Right, let's have it on, we are struggling to get up this hill. Oh, actually, there's not really a hill, we're just struggling to get up some speed. Hold on, let's put it on, should we have it on 8%? No. Oh, I don't know what's wrong with this tank engine, hold on. I'm just trying random things. It's picking up speed, but very slowly. But anyway, let's go back inside, because I really want to show you how well detailed this is. Because look, you get a shovel. I would open this, but you know it won't let me because the thing's on automatic. But you get all these awesome like dials and clock things and boiler temperatures and coal pressure, which is really cool. And I really like that. And we're picking up speed. Hold on. Oh, we are picking up some speed now. That's cool. Let's go out here again, because I really like this position. Oh look, you can see the sparks about just flying from the funnel. But I'm so grateful for Mark for letting me have this as a gift. And guys, please subscribe to his YouTube channel, Mark the Blue Brony, and you know, thank you Mark for letting me have this as a gift. And you know what? I'm glad you did, because I think this is worth every second of it. Right, we're cruising, well actually we're not really cruising, we're speeding at a very steady 30 miles per hour, and we are coming up to the bottom of the hill. But at the top of this hill, I know for a fact there's a station up here called Watch something or other. But when I get to the top of the hill, I'm going to stop at that station and we are going to close off the video. But you know, because we've only got so little time left, I'm very glad I did a review on this. And there's not really much to review. I mean, it's just a tank engine, really. But I'm not saying that as a horrible way. I mean, the detail in there, in this tank engine, is so fan-bloody-tastic. And I'm glad. I am so glad I did a review on that. And, you know, I keep saying it's all thanks to Mark, the Blue Brony. But without him, I wouldn't have actually done this review on this amazing train, so I'm so happy. And I'm just going to keep playing with this for hours and hours. And, you know, the detail in the coal is quite impressive. But, I mean, they could have done better, but what can you do? It's a model. Leave it alone. Right, so we're coming up to the end of the station, which is at the very top of the hill. Washford, that's what it was called. It's called a Washford. I wash my Ford because it's my Ford's a car. Right, let's... actually, we can keep the power on for now, until we get round about here, but after that then we have to pull power, slow down and stop at the station and just do what I'm good at. Oh no, we're losing speed, oh no, we're losing speed, 25%, there we go, we're picking up some speed again, hooray! Well actually, there's no need for a hooray, because our station is just coming up, so you know, just, that was pointless, just ignore me, that was totally pointless. Right around this corner, I think our station should be in sight. Right now. There it is! Our station is in sight! Right, we could pull a little bit of power off. Like so. There we go. And all we were doing was just rolling. Oh, no, we meant to press 2, not 3. We're just rolling. I'm not doing anything. It's just rolling on its own. But now we have to apply the brakes, but not too much. Come on. Come on, my pretty. Come on. Come on. Right, apply the brakes. Gently, not too much. A bit more, not too much. A little bit more. Right, here we go. Stop. Hello. Oh, hello, people. Well, that might have made them jump. But here we are. We've arrived. Hooray, we have arrived. Open doors. Let people on and off. There we go. What a success. What a lovely success. Well, people, thank you for watching this episode of Train Simulator 2017. I will see you again next time for another Train Simulator 2017 episode, but the next time will be quite a surprise because I'm really excited to I can't tell you because I'm going to keep it as a surprise, but I can't wait for it till it comes out, probably in the next week or so. But thank you guys so much for watching this episode, and I'll see you guys next time on another Train Simulator episodes. But in the meantime, stay cool, my friends.